Okay. Test 1, 2, test. Okay. Excuse me, everybody out there, if you're listening, we're going to get some volume adjusting here. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, test 1, 2. Test 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Test 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Testing. Test, test, test. Test, test, test. Got to get the right side. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Test 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Test 1-2. Test 1-2, 1-2-3-4. Testing 1-2, 1-2-3-4. Testing 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Got the left, but not the right. Testing, testing. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2.
Testing.
Testing. Hello. Control room.
Testing 1 2 3 4 testing 1 2. Testing 1 2 3 4 testing. Both sides. Testing 1 2 3 4.
Got a minute 38 remaining in the first quarter of the JV game, with Elder leading 11-6. After one quarter, it's Elder 11, LaSalle 8. Thank you.
How's it sound for you? Too loud? Testing 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. See, I'm up in the red there.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Testing 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2.
50.5 seconds remaining in the first half of the junior varsity game. The LaSalle 25-22 here at the pit. good. Rebounded by LaSalle. Just looking at 30 seconds remaining on the first half. Lance is leading by three here. Oh, the shot is up and good. Time score here at the pit, the JV game, the South 27 over 22. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing.
Testing.
Working. Testing 1, 2.
Testing 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right. It's pretty clear. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, you not hearing it? Oh, okay. Good. guys are watching the end of the varsity game here. And just under a minute to go. Elder's up by six right now. Four-point game here. Man, it's a long time to get it out here and get it up four. Time out. Got herself stuck in a corner there. About 54 seconds here. Let's see if they can control it. Get up the court and keep it under control. No foul. I think the rest of the game's been nothing but fouls. So I sure hope the boys can put it through the hoops there. Let's get some net. That ball, yep. Okay. So I got a foot on that one. So let's hopefully we'll make the same mistake. All right, get across the court now. Just relax, guys. Right. Back to the free throw line. Let's put him in. 30 point seconds of lead yet. Trying to make it interesting. Too interesting for my blood, guys. Seconds here, up by four. Point 6 seconds. We're up by four. Back to free throw line. Oh my God, it's the wine. Alright, there you go. I'm five now. One more at the line. Still fighting all the way to the ending. We've learned some of these games that we've lost by not playing all the way through. We've got 9 seconds to go. We're up by five. Back from the line. Everybody staying back for out everybody up on the line. The shooter's by himself. Feel no pressure, boy. JV won 61-55 tonight. That was a good game, but they played through the whole thing, all the good things. You can see the freshmen, they lost. It was tough. They were winning most of the game, and it was fourth quarter there. They kind of let it slip away, but they played a good game. All right, guys. We'll be getting ready for the varsity game, and luckily you're going to be talking to Zach and who else. We got Ryan there, so I want to turn it over to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, after all that, we're ready for basketball on Friday night. We got the Panthers. We got the Panthers on Saturday against the LaSalle Lancers. And after a run, we should be set for a great game tonight. What are some keys for LaSalle?
LaSalle, man, they got to get the ball to C.J. Fleming, and they got to let him score. He's the motor of their offense. He's a guy that makes everything work. And we saw that when he was hurt earlier in the year, they had some trouble scoring the ball. But now that he's back, they got to go to him as much as possible. What about for Elder here?
Elder, I think the important thing is that Carter's been the hot hand, if you will. He can shoot and lights out. And I think they got to be able to work the ball. And the ball movement, and then check out, get some open looks from the outside.
It looks like they got an early foul there on CJ. It's his first, obviously.
LaSalle, of course, only has 8 guys dressed, so that's going to be something to watch. They can't afford to get too much foul trouble.
There's Trent Krigler with the ball there, passing to Big Brandon. Down to Hartman on the block. Blew the layup.
Nice job. No, it's tough. Zach Hartman's going to have to guard Hartman down there. I'm sure it's not ideal, but good start there.
Nice shot by Hartman.
I lost it. Nice hustle play by Dabo. Getting a start on senior night.
Yeah, that's what you got to need. That's what the Panthers are going to need here if they're going to come away with a win. LaSalle, one of the best teams in the city. They're going to need to get all the 50-50 balls to settle the turnover.
That's Mosley who got turned over, and Big Brandon who can't finish on the land. It goes out of bounds. It'll stay with LaSalle.
Coach Schoenfeld doesn't like the call there.
I think they're about to change it, but keep it here with LaSalle.
Krigler, defended by Connor, passes to Brandon. To Hartman on the high post. Back to Brandon, who sets up shot from three. I just read about my nose. Here's Harp. As you said, he's the heart and soul of this offense, leading scorer the past couple of games. Offensively, I mean, Elders can need some movement here. A lot of standing around the early on. We saw this in the Moeller game a little bit to start the game. It's a great move. Nice move. That breaks the trout there for Elder, a little flotation device in the lane.
Averaging 4.5 points a game. It's a nice try by Kirkland.
He's really an undervalued player at LaSalle. He does a lot and doesn't get a lot of credit for it.
He's been a 3-year starter for the Lancers. And that's open look, Harp. Not able to get it to drop.
That's a rarity there. Harp had all day and it just misfired.
Wide open.
Riley Hubner, pass to Fleming.
Nice job. They're not allowing him to get too much.
Looks like Coach Schoenfeld drew up a good game plan here. Yeah. CJ hasn't been getting many touches, and when he does, it can swarm him. His Krigler hits a deep three. 5-2 LaSalle early on.
He can really shoot it.
He's got all five for LaSalle. Most of it with the ball top the key, defended by Riley Hobner. As Sullivan is defended by C.J. Plummer.
And one.
Oh, no, they got a block before.
And one, they give it to travel.
The crowd doesn't like it.
Now, Coach Schoenfeld wants to play sideline.
Tate Brandon with the ball, strays the floor. By CJ on the back cut, draws a foul and shoot two. That looks to be on Deshaun Mosley. It is on Deshaun Mosley. And Elder, they cannot afford to have Deshaun in foul trouble tonight.
Yeah.
He's their best rebounder on senior night, obviously. And he's really kind of the heart and soul of their entire team.
CJ Fleming knocks down the first free throw. He shoots it nearly 90% from the line. Very, very good stroke. Fleming, of course, a 4-year starter.
Bellarmine commit. They'll be playing D2 basketball next year. The prestigious D2 school. Stanhope gets a shot off.
Fleming leads the GCL in scoring. His value is just priceless for his team. Martin gets fouled.
Yeah, he just out-rebounded there. Just flat out took the ball away from Sean Sullivan.
Hartman is pretty tall. He's 6'7". Tallest guy on that floor for either team. And this is the first rebound.
Brady Connor and Deshaun Mosley to take a seat for Elder, and Brett Marsh and Jacob Bryan check in. 1 out of 2 for Hartman at the line. 8-2 ball game. Sean Sullivan, top of the floor, dribbles in the corner. Finds that step out to Sullivan. He gets it to Harp. Good defense by Crick.
Yeah, he's no longer.
Estep, who's been a nice young player to see for Elder.
Yeah. It's a good defensive set from the sound. We're not giving the Panthers much here.
Nice defense by CJ. Harden, a foul call. Okay. A beautiful find by CJ down at the meet Brandon for an easy two. That's an 8-point lead here.
Well, this court victory is ridiculous.
We thought Elder might have some offensive troubles coming into the game, and we thought right because they got 2 points, and there's about 2 minutes and 50 seconds left here in the first quarter.
Yeah. It's a struggle. You're just not getting a lot of good open looks early on in the game.
Looks like for LaSalle, Sam Hildebrand checks in for Nick Brandon.
Henry Loudon also checked in.
Nice cut by Hildebrand. Open 15-footer. He knocks it down.
That's a tough shot. Zach Burke's going to need to make if Elder can win this game.
There's CJ, defended by O'Brien, finds Hartman atop the high post. Nice back cut. Hartman, he's a good passer.
That's deep.
Wow.
Oh, Trey Krigler. That was way out. That's what they'll do. He's a really, really good shooter. He's averaging 13 points a game.
Quinn Ealy checks in for the sack. First time we've seen it tonight.
And they've emptied their bench. They only have 8 healthy players, and they're using them. There's one knock we're going to have on the set. That might be it for depth. If they get in foul trouble, they're vulnerable. But when they've got those guys healthy, they're really, really good.
Definitely one of the best teams in the city. Only got a couple losses. Bowler being two of them. But one of those games, they didn't have CJ, so you can't really. That's a little move in traffic there by Solder. You like to see that.
Look at that job. I think he's gotten better as the season's gone on. He's had some games, there in a game or two, where he really was a big part of the offense. He was tough inside. He likes to get to the basket. That's a nice job of Solder on that last.
You don't really see him create his own shots too much. So to see him do that tonight when Elder's struggling, that's definitely a good sign. Brandon will bring the ball to the front court for LaSalle. There's Riley Hobner on the wing. Takes it himself. Nice pass in the corner.
Hobner is pretty lengthy. I mean, he's going about 6'1", maybe he's 145 soaking wet.
Fleming defended by the sophomore Jake O'Brien. Takes himself. Difficult shot.
Yeah, that's why he's that good. He pull off Jay, that's a tough one.
You can't do much about that if you're Elder. I mean, you defend him from half court. You got him, you had it right in his jersey and the face, and he just made the better shot.
And there is a reason he's the best player in the city. And those tough shots, he's able to hit. He's hit many in his career like that, and a couple of his children.
Good defense, just better offense. Brett Marsh fires in the corner. He's off. Nice rebound by LaShawn. Nearly loses it. Gets it to O'Brien. He takes it inside. It scores.
That was a good job. Quarter ends. We'll take a quick break.
back, about to resume play here. For Elder, I think Zach, offensively, they need to pick up the pace a little bit, maybe get out in transition and run a little bit more,
yeah.
Get some easy baskets, because in the half court, they haven't really been scoring too much.
They definitely look a little lethargic, I'd say. They're just not really getting a lot of looks, and that's a credit to LaSalle's defense. They played really tough. They haven't given them much, so I credit LaSalle's team early on. Jake Trigler is doing stuff like that, but it can go down.
That's rebound there by Estep. He'll take it himself.
Another thing I noticed in that first quarter, Elder's got 8 points. He got four different guys at least in ball, four different guys with 2 points each. So it's good to see some different guys getting involved. As I step, they got five different Panthers on the board.
Nice little shimmy shot there from a three-point line.
Oh, wow. These back shots. Nice job.
LaSalle's so hard to defend because since they have so many three-point shooters on the floor, you got to play out, and that leaves the back cut open.
Yeah,
with Hartman at the top of the key, he's a terrific passer. Very difficult.
They're getting those, you know, good back cuts. That's been a problem. That's a deep three. Hart. He struggled a bit shooting the ball early in the season, but he has raised his three-point percentage a lot over the last five, six games or so. It's been a treat to watch.
Oh, man, we got two of the best scorers in the GCL tonight, C.J. Fleming and Zach Hart. Two guards that love to shoot the ball. As it looks like Denise Brandon throws a foul there on Braden Connor. Shoot two.
That last three by Zach Hart, it's big. Because you don't want to let LaSalle get too far out ahead, you know. You cut it to four. We've seen comebacks in this building, but we don't have a team quite like those a couple years ago. So, got to hang around if you're older.
I completely agree. If Albert gets down, you know, 10-plus here, it's going to be very difficult to come back. He makes 2-for-2 there for Demeek. The S-step dribbles the ball. Finds Mosley. Nice move.
Nice job. Wow. Panther 3 of 5 points. Six different Panthers have scored. 5:58 left in the second quarter.
That play was made by Deshaun Mosley. He made a couple nice head fakes, threw the defense in, kicked it out in the corner for a wide open Brett Marsh.
Walker lost the ball, and Hart got fouled by Walker.
That's the hustle we're talking about there. 50-50 ball, Elder comes up with it.
I'll bring Heinrich Lyles back into the game.
Looks like Coach Fleming was barking at one of the refs, and I got a confer up here.
Well, they call it a jump ball. I just said I thought it was a foul.
I think they called a foul originally, too.
Yeah.
They must have changed that call there.
Regardless, it's Elder basketball.
3-point game. Sean Sullivan, the top of the court, finds Estep on the wing, defended by Demeek Brandon. Dribbles, looking for an open player, finds Brandon Connor. Mixed match, defended by Hartman, to get it to Mosley. The foul's over, Henry Loden. Back to Mosley. Hart defended by Fleming. It's a matchup you want to mark.
Oh, nice. That lost in the shuffle, but it's going to stay with him.
Brett Marsh is getting ready to check back into the game for, looks like Sean Sullivan. Brady Connor will be the inbound man.
Ah, tough pass. That tip to Webb was fairly low.
And the pass just got a little bit tougher now as they're far further in the corner now.
It's going to be a difficult inbound for the Panthers.
Get it into a test up there. Mostly fires for three.
Oh. Regular trying to run and they'll slow it down on Brandon.
Allen looks good for Mosley.
Yeah, it did.
There's that to meet Brandon, defended by Hart. There's Fleming, dribble handoff, loses the ball, gets it back. Gets a screen from Hartman.
They're doing a good job. They're not letting Fleming get in too many easy looks. The shot at DJ was a tough pull-up. And then he got a couple of free throws. So, they're doing a pretty good job. They're not leaving Fleming open.
It looks like what they're doing is right when Fleming gets the ball, they're bringing the nearest defender, and they're giving a little bit more cushion on Fleming there. Which is smart by Coach Schoenfeld. You know, this LaSalle team coming in. Make anybody but CJ beat you.
Yeah.
Looks like we got a timeout on the floor as well. We'll be back after a short break. Alrighty, and we're back. I'm Ryan Rule alongside my partner Zach Freeze as Brady Connor takes the ball out to Zach Hart. What's different for Elder here in the second half? Or in the second quarter?
Well, I think just the Zach Hart being Zach Hart, he's hit some big shots. Yeah, I think the ball movement's been a little better. You're going to see Mars who airmails at three. So, like I said, Motors got to hang around. We've seen crazier, games in this building. They hang around, keep it in 3 to 5 point deficit. As long as they don't get down by double digits or more, they can definitely win this ballgame.
I agree. Hartman, high post, dribble handoff to Fleming. Back to Hartman. Bobner to the rim. What a finish. Yeah. Wow.
Bobner gets his first bucket of the game. That was tough.
Double clutch over Deshaun.
Yeah.
Oh, a lot of contact there.
That's a foul. Yeah. He got hit there pretty good. With a handoff.
If I'm Elder here offensively, it looks like there's Salas switching ball screens. I try and get Hartman matched up with a three-point shooter. They're trying to get a look because right now they can't find much.
I'm going to put the front and nose it down the paint. He's trying to not let him get the ball.
Nice pass.
Nice job.
Jab up for three.
Did you see Dave Gabel on the board on senior night?
He's truly one of the most stand-up guys you'll ever meet.
Yeah. He plays really, really hard, too. We've seen him dive on the ground for loose balls.
Wow, and they call a foul there. And they didn't call a foul in the last possession.
Yeah, I don't understand that one. Little bit two on Connor, too, so... He's going to have to take a seat.
Yeah, and Harp right back in there. There's the beat Brandon with the ball. Finds Krigler. Fires.
Not this time.
Good rebound by Dabo.
That's what I'm talking about. He plays hard. He does the dirty work for him.
Oh, Mosley, a little shaking face.
He is on the board for the first time.
Game is tied. CJ for three. Got it.
That's a big-time shot for Corning there.
Yeah, not to keep saying the same thing over and over again, but when CJ shoots the ball, you're surprised if he misses.
Yeah.
He shoots at such a high percentage.
He does. It looked like a travel to get it.
Yeah, that was a good call there.
CJ Fleming will get a quick breather.
It looks like he wasn't not too happy with his dad there who took him out. That's kind of a Riley Hobner, the Hartman. Top 3-point line finds Meek Brandon, defended by Brett Marsh. Henry Loudon with the ball. Good defense by Dabo. Finds Rob Hobner again. Back to Loudon. Back to Hobner. Dabo is defending. Loudon's corner. Three ball.
Got it. Loudon. He's averaging under 2 points a game, so he gets that three.
Just like that. Elder tied the game up. And then the Celtics 2-3 to extend it to six.
Yeah, that was a big shot. Kind of a little bit of a momentum killer, if there is. But they need a good possession to end the half here. Maybe get a basket.
I try and get something going to the basket here, draw a foul. Brett Marsh sets up shot. No good.
And now, Trigler. Past half court, a little off.
Looks like a grazed iron, though.
And we'll take a break as we got halftime here. Elder trails LaSalle 27-21.
Oh my God. we're back. I'm Ryan Rule alongside my partner Zach Freeze here. We're about to begin the second half. LaSalle opened up a 6-point lead here after the first half. What do you think Elder needs to do to claw their way back into the game?
Well, you know, patience is key offensively. They got to have ball movement. They've pushed that all year. Take care of the basketball. Listen, you're only down 6 points. You got to get Zach Corbin some open looks. You're going to have to knock down some shots. Defensively, they aren't playing too bad. Got to watch the backdoor cuts. I think they did a pretty good job on CJ. He made that tough. He made a good three, but other than that, he hasn't killed us too much. But what does LaSalle need to keep doing, right?
Well, I say one there by Sean Solomon, but to answer your question, they need to continue what they've been doing. I think they played a great first half. They need to keep running their offense through the high post with Hartman and those back cuts. It's really hard for Elder to defend that. And then defensively, you just want to make Elder
a great rebound. Almost forever.
Almost 3 seconds as well. But defensively for LaSalle, you want to force Elder into some tough shots and turnovers. That's what they need to do. Is stop Sullivan and just score the and one as the ball here. Tough shot by Mosley.
Short arm, that one just got front iron.
Demeek Brandon with the ball. Finds Riley Hopper. Here's Hartman, high post, just as I mentioned. Hands off to Krigler. Rise and fire for about 18. He's got it.
He's been the killer tonight. He's got 12 points to lead to LaSalle. He's hit some deep threes, but that today, that's a tough one, too. But he's a really, really good shooter. I can't stress it enough.
Sullivan tries to put his head down and get past Hartman. Hartman wasn't having any of
them, but by Elders, Marsh.
Oh, yes, he's honest.
Boy, he did everything right. He made a nice move with the bucket, but he couldn't get the fit.
Classic million-dollar move with the 10-cent finish there.
Yeah. Hartman got a good race. Yeah, Fleming. Almost saved if he's out of bounds.
Brett Marsh with the ball, defended by Hopper, gets it to Sean Sullivan. He'll dribble in the front court.
Hopper trying to pester Mosley from behind.
One thing I think Elder needs to try and attack, we need to start his heart sets up shot deep.
Yeah,
he fires, but Marsh tries for the rebound, doesn't get it. Hartman doesn't move very much defensively. I think they can maybe try and find a weakness there. Every other LaSalle player moves very well.
That's a good backup. Yeah, Brandon's out there. That's a problem when Harp struggles a bit defensively. It's hard to keep up with these quick guards like Brandon.
An 8-point game, and Sullivan puts his head down and draws a foul.
Coach Fleming not happy with his son.
No, he's laying into him a little bit. Anybody who was coached by their father kind of knows the special bond that, like that CJ has with his dad. It's definitely something special. I mean, you kind of love to see it in high school sports. Two for two for Sullivan there. David Denbaugh checks in, as well as Jacob Bryan.
And Sean Sullivan, 6 points, he leads the way for the Panthers. A little bit of a surprise, but you've got some balance.
Yeah, he's not a guy you expect a lot of scoring out of, more of a great kind of player. But whenever you get scoring, that's always a positive, as Krigler finds Hopner on the win. Jamie Brandon will take the ball, defended by David Dabell. There's Trent Krigler, leading scorer for LaSalle.
I
don't know if that was a pass or a loss, but either way.
That was impressive. I don't know how that got to Hartman. O'Brien tried to play physical with Hartman down there.
Nice defense.
Six steal. Yeah, they had that back door cut there. A little sloppy, and they got a run out. There goes down layup.
Yeah, LaSalle calls timeout. That's just too much there for Deshaun. You make a good play on the defensive end, and then you come down and try and get a little too fancy, going through the legs a couple times, and you lose the ball. And that's up for 2 points for LaSalle. But for Elder, I really, even though they're down eight, I kind of like the way they're playing in the second half. Like they're getting the ball inside. You saw Sean Sullivan score an and one.
Yep.
Marsh out to the rim, and
he just
blew it. That's the way you got to play. A lot of times, Elder likes to live outside the three-point line. Hart making tough shots, Brett Marsh making tough shots. But if they can get inside and get some easy baskets, that kind of opens everything up. What did you say?
Yeah, and that's the key. But for Elder, it's about the swings. You can't have those turnovers and then, you know, give up a layup on an easy layup like that coming back. That's a big swing in this game, you know. You got a chance to cut it to, you know, 4 or 5 points. And then, you know, you have that now, you're down eight. You can't have that.
Elder is trying to win their very first home GCL game this year. Deshaun Mosley defended by Fleming.
And a lot of standing around a little bit there. Everyone's around the team. Marsh off the mark on the three.
Coach Stroud shakes his head there. He didn't like that offensive possession very much.
Got a foul. We'll get Brett Marsh for it.
Nice little fake handoff to Fleming. Nice piece of floater. Mosley defended by Hartman. Stutter step. And side cross foul. And if you're Elder here, there's a lot of time left in this game, but you kind of want to make a little bit of a run. You want to get it a little bit closer because, as you mentioned earlier, as Deshaun makes the first two free throws, CJ and the rest of the guards for LaSalle are terrific free throw shooters. So down the stretch of the game, he makes a second there. If he has to foul, you're in some trouble.
Yeah. Deshaun knows a little bit of a quiet night. He's only got 3 points. Pardon, I think Mosley has 4 points, but regardless, he's having a bit of a tough time. You know, we saw him score with ease at times early in the season. I wonder if maybe that finger injury bothered him a little bit. But
yeah, Elder definitely expects a little bit more production than 4 points, as he's one of the leading scorers on the team as well as the league, the GCL. So, follow that development here. Trigler out of control to the basket.
Mosley attacks.
Another missed layup.
Goodness. And that's two of them in a half, but they make a 3 point loss.
Nice defense by Mosley. He almost loses the ball. Smart play there to kick it out. No good by Estep. Rebound corralled by Slevin. Good fake on the baseline. Finds Hobner, who finds Hartman. Back to Hobner. Another foul call.
We'll get this step.
About it to Joe Hartman, who finds to meet Brandon. Here's Fleming, defended by Brett Morris. Oh, he's moved. Could have been a moving screen call there on Hartman.
Possibly.
Didn't see it. LaSalle resets. That's defense again.
Well, the ball rolled LaSalle's play there.
Yeah, but if you're Elder, you want to keep doing that. Keep getting those deflections. Eventually, I'll fall your way. That's just unlucky.
Yeah, they're starting to read those back screens a little bit better. And, but a little bit of a back right there, a little sloppy.
It looks like Coach Schoenfeld made a good adjustment at halftime. Panthers are sniffing out those back cuts very well.
If you think about it, like a play like that, you know, a little bit of bad luck, and then you got those two missed wide open layups pretty much.
Yeah, it adds up.
Yeah,
it adds up. Hart sets up shot. It's not been his night.
Yeah, you're right. Elder's struggling a little bit. Hart is with that three-point jumper. He's not getting out the ball.
But if you're Elder, you want to keep seeing him shoot the ball. The best way for a shooter to get out of his slump is to keep shooting. So.
Oh,
and they got an offensive foul. Questionable call. That one could have went either way. It's tough to tell if the LaSalle defender was set or not, but Trey Creekler, the leading scorer for the Lancers today. Hands off to Fleming, who finds Brandon to Hopper. Good ball move for the Lancers here as they find Creekler here. Excuse me.
You're looking like they might work to get the last shot possibly.
That's got to be 5 seconds as Brent Martin comes up with the steal.
Take out, or they need to score here. With about 13 seconds.
Left. Hold for one shot. Smart play by the senior, Brandon Connor.
No time to go. You got 5 seconds.
He sets up a shot.
Off the mark.
Half court heave is off. So at the end of three, the LaSalle Lancers lead your Elder Panthers 35-27. We'll be back after a short break.
We're back here at the pit. We're just about ready to play in the fourth quarter. Elder does trail LaSalle 35-27. As Trey Kringler has been the leading scorer for the Lancers, he's got 14 points. On the other end for Elder, Sean Sullivan has led the balance attack. He's got 6 points of his own. Tough shot. Fleming and one.
And he's just one hell of a competitor.
That was a tough shot.
All right, I got a GCL update here. About 20 minutes ago, it was halftime over at St. X. The Bombers trail Moeller 37-13. Moeller, they're still undefeated. Definitely one of the top teams in the city. Fleming converts the old-fashioned three-point play as a 11-point lead for Elder.
Oh, run him out. Sloppy.
Sean, his problem there is he went down for a dribble. He put it down. He brought the ball down low, and all the guards could rip at it and steal it. As a taller player, you got to keep the ball up high where you can put it back real easy and you don't have any problems with the guards. There he turned the ball over.
Yeah. And he struggled with the turn, and then he turned it over again after down there and under the basket. And then Peter Hoffman just did. Elder's going to go now. They're down 11 with 6 minutes to go. They're going to have to get it going quick.
Nice move there. Sullivan misfires. Give a lot of credit to this LaSalle defense. 27 points here in the fourth quarter for Elder. Definitely one of the stories of the game is Hobner. Nice move. Wow, that is an awesome move there by Riley Hobner. As he just blew by Sean Mosen with his head fake.
That was a really nice job by Riley Hobner.
LaSalle takes a timeout here. And for Elder, are they out of this game, Zach?
I'm not going to say they're out of this game. There's still some time left. But there needs to be a sense of urgency. You're down 13 points. Just over 6 minutes to go. They're going to need to get a little lucky. They're going to need some shots to fall. And they can't have those turnovers. And, you know, it's not over until it's over, but it's not looking good for Elder. They need some offensive rhythm here.
You know, it's a real shame. I agree the game's not over, but, man, can you imagine what kind of ball game we would have if you cut down on the turnovers and we make our layups?
LaSalle
might not be sitting so comfortably right now.
Right.
Here we go. It's Elder basketball. We'll see what Coach Schoenfeld draws up. See if we get Elder a basket here. It's hard. Gives the ball right back to Brady Connor. Stop continues to play a man-to-man. Oh!
That's a good play by CJ.
Yeah, that was a great play by CJ. That was also a great play call by Coach Cho. CJ just sniffed it out. Hobner again. They got foul on the ground. Hobner again.
Another red one.
I That's a big basket for LaSalle. CJ calls out, looks like what to be motivation to his teammates. That's one thing that you kind of value. Everybody talks about what he does on the court. Nobody really mentions how good of a leader he actually is.
Yeah, when you're a point guard in the UCL for 4 years, yeah. You're starting point guard at
the varsity level, exactly.
You're going to, see all kinds of situations in that 4 years. He's been out there for the Alexis. The three by Marsh, no good. Maybe he takes another time to fall.
Plumbing. Shot takes a three. Just about everybody in the building thought he was going to help him.
Long pass from Plumbing. Got it underneath. He had to ball. The outer ball.
You know, Plumbing's got 10 points tonight. He hasn't really shot the ball that much.
Yeah.
I mean, he's had some free throws. He got a three-pointer. Although, pull up from the free throw line in the first quarter. But he hasn't really shot the ball that much. It's kind of surprising.
Yeah.
I mean, he hasn't had to. His teammates have been on fire. Marks, an open look.
They need that. That's not going to fall. A foul on Martin.
Yeah, Coach Fleming's not happy about that. Bourbon with a distinct size advantage on Trevor Estep. He's called for a foul, boxing out. Your elder is Brady Connor. No hesitation, fire from the corner. He's got it.
I don't take anything they can get at this point. Quarter and a half to go.
That might get the juices flowing a little bit offensively. CJ defended by Marsh. They got a foul call on Marsh there. Looks like Fleming is going to the line.
Not a smart foul either. CJ Fleming getting a one and one. He's almost automatic at the line.
Yeah, one of the best shooters in the city. CJ there. He's got 12 points. As Dave Dabell checks back in. 15-point lead from the South.
Well, when you're that good of a three-point shooter, that good of a player, too, having the dedication CJ puts in it to be that great of a free-throw shooter, and it's a lot of time and effort.
Yeah, it's really something you admire, even if you're not a South fan. You got to respect everything that he's done. Truly one of the strongest work ethics in basketball, especially in the city of Cincinnati for high school. He had a tough night.
Yeah. Only 5 points from that card.
He's missed some open looks. He's missed some tough shots, both of which he usually hits. CJ almost loses the ball. Lucky to come up with it there. Looks like LaSalle almost in their four corners offense, milking the clock. Obner has a wide open look at a three. Passed on it.
Ebel. Oh. Right. Ebel looked like he had a steal there. So he hit the ice trap and he lost the ball. And that kind of night for Ebel.
Ebel but this isn't the end for Elder. They got a couple big games coming up. Tomorrow, they play North Mott here in a bit. Definitely a game, a very winnable game they have. And then next Friday, they play at Moeller, which the outlook of that game isn't good. You know, Moeller's top 20 in the nation, actually. And they took care of business here in the pit, but, you know, that's a resume win if Albert can get the job done.
Yeah, I mean, the tear that Moeller's been on is pretty unprecedented. I knew they'd have a great squad this year, but to be undefeated is something special.
About to resume play. It's the South Lancer basketball. Nice catch by CJ, the baseline.
An update from Moeller X is Moeller the pacing at 53-30. That's fourth quarter, 6 minutes left. That's just from a minute ago. Moeller will stay on the field in the net. Again, LaSalle just milking clock.
Yeah, this four-corner offense, I mean, I guess it's good. I guess you could say it's good coaching by Coach Fleming, but LaSalle's not going to shoot the ball unless they have a layup now. Because they've got a 15-point lead, and it's just over 2 minutes left. They're not going to force anything. They're going to want Elder to foul them, and that's just the senior leadership they have on this team. Realize, hey, we're up big. We don't need to make anything happen here. We can just move the ball and make Elder force the action.
So Hartman at the line is just 1 point.
And I guess he's the guy you want to foul. Everyone else is such a good foul shot shooter.
Donner was the leading scorer. He's got 7 points.
He's off on the foul shot. And an obvious foul there. And not a good one. It's Deshaun Mosley goes over the back of CJ.
You don't want to give a team 3 points in the basement. You don't want to have to be fouled in the weather.
And with that free throw there, Fleming ties Krigler for the LaSalle game high scoring. Is Fleming's got 14 and Krigler's got 14. All right, and we're about to resume here. Elder's down 15, 207 left. Not looking too good, but it's not over just yet. Hard defended by Trey Krigler. Now Fleming loses the ball out of bounds. LaSalle basketball.
Quick update. Oak Hill's playing Princeton in the yard. Oak Hill's, they're winning big up to the 21. I did the third. That was 10 minutes ago. From Adam Holland.
Now that last play for Elder there is kind of the story of the game. You know, you have the ball, you have the chance to, you know, cut into the LaSalle deficit, you just turn it over. You don't even get a shot off.
And it's been a story of a lot of late-game struggles for Elder this season. You look against Oak Hills and Nolan, and they had opportunities in those games. And turnovers late in games, and you lost out of those games.
Part of that is they got a group of young guys, Oliver does. They only, you know, they got four seniors, but, you know, they don't, about two of them, you know, play, two or three of them play a lot. So, you know, they're playing a lot of sophomores and juniors, a lot of juniors especially, with Park and Marsh, yeah. And Esna. Some guys who really haven't had the, as much experience at the varsity level. So, that could be the answer for those turnovers there. It's just work it out, work the kinks out for next year.
Connor will get a lay-in to go.
Elder calls timeout after a made basket by Grant Connor. A 14-point game with a 1:26 left. I suppose Moeller, they won't beat St. X, as you said, they're up big, locks up the GCL for that win. LaSalle has the basketball. Fleming. Trapped. Finds Hartman. Who's fouled? Smart foul there. He'll get two shots now.
Personal add to the tumble. He's got 2 points.
You know, Hartman, you know, now he's got three, but you can't just look at the scoring column and say, you know, decide whether the players had a good game or not. Right. Because Hartman, man, he's only got 3 points as Hart fires a deep three. It's off, coming a rebound. You know, Hartman's only got 3 points, but, man, he creates so much of that offense on the high post. He's got, he's tall, he's the tallest guy on the floor, like you said earlier. He can see over the defense and just make those backdoor cuts, make those passes to the backdoor cutters for easy lay-ins, just, you know, what he did tonight. Plus, he's their leading rebounder as well.
I have a foul here from Devil. Foul from Grant Miller. Both teams get their benches.
Those are the four seniors there that check out their final GCL home game.
great jumper. No good.
Wow, what an athletic play. Save the ball, find an open player, and get it to him. All while in the air.
And it looks like Craig Kribler gets to not dribble off the clock.
It's a pleasure broadcasting the game with you tonight, Zach. It was a shame the Panthers couldn't get the job done, but we'll be back tomorrow, Northmont.
Always a pleasure, Ryan. Thanks for tuning in to EA Sports, signing off.